Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to explain about wait commands in Selenium with Python. Now, before going to discuss about wait commands, let us understand what is synchronization problem in automation. So in every automation tool, normally we will see this kind of issue. So that's called a synchronization. So for example, when you write your automation code, right? So the execution will happen top to bottom, so each and every statement will execute, and correspondingly, so it will also open up the pages and it will talk to this particular elements which are present in a web page, right? Now for example, sometimes what happens is when I'm executing the code, so particular code or particular line of the script is required for some element. Okay, it has to perform some action on the element, and by that time element is not available here. Okay, by that time element is not available, and what happens is script will not wait for that element. Immediately it will jump to the next statement. So here it will throw an exception, so element not visible, no such element. So these kind of exception it will be thrown. So this is the one again. So one more scenario is, for example, I have two different pages. This is our page one and this is a page two, and some part of the code is interacted with the page one, and the other part of the code need to interact with the page number two. And when I try to execute our second part of the code, by the time the second page is not displayed, so it will not wait for the second page. It will directly go and execute the other statements, and it will throw whichever page is required for that particular statement. If it could not find that particular page, it will throw again an exception. So this is problem of synchronization. So synchronization is basically balancing between the code execution and also response of application. So if you see this particular problem, so how we can fix this problem? So there are two ways. One is we can make our application faster, or we can wait for some time, or we can pass our code for some time to display that element on the page. So if you see these particular two solutions, application speed we cannot increase because this is not in our hand. But there are so many parameters or criteria will be there. Sometimes because of network speed is very slow, application response is very slow, and sometimes more people are accessing this application, so maybe that is the reason also it becomes application slow, right? So there are many factors which we don't have control on this. So this side we cannot fix it, but the code whatever we have written, that is in completely in our control. So here we can control our code execution. So what we can do is, whichever statement is looking for certain element, okay, if we want to wait for that element, we can just insert some wait command here or wait statement, and we need to specify some time also. So that what happens is, now when I try to execute our code, it will pause our execution for some time, and meanwhile the element or page will be completely loaded, and then it will identify element, and then it will proceed the rest of the statements. So this is a synchronization problem, and this is how we need to solve the synchronization problem. So in WebDriver, there are two types of wait statements we have: implicit wait and explicit wait. And WebDriver is supporting these two types of waits. So now in this video, I'm going to explain about implicit wait, how to use implicit wait command. Okay. Now to do this, I'm just going to write a small automation code. Let's create a new Python file. So I will name it as implicit wait. Okay. So here what I will do is I'll put implicit wait command, and before that I'll just automate a small scenario. So let me just take this particular website. So here, as soon as you open the page, okay, so here after opening this URL, let us take some time to landing this particular page. Okay, so I will wait for till the complete page is loaded, and also I will wait for this element and password, and then I will click on the sign in button, right? So let us see how we can use this implicit wait command for this particular scenario. So before that, let me start writing the code. So let me open PyCharm. So here, what is the first thing we need to do? We have to import the required packages from Selenium. We have to import WebDriver, and what next? We need to also import okay, so what are other things we require? So this is enough. So we have to just create the driver now. Driver is equal to web driver dot, I'm using Chrome driver, Chrome, and here executable underscore path we require. Executable underscore path is equal to in the double quotes, and this is a lowercase status, right? So executable underscore path is equal to, and in the double quotations we need to specify the complete path of my Chrome driver. Now specify this path, and then the next step, so we need to open the URL. So driver dot get, and here we need to specify the URL of the application. Now this is the URL of the application, specify this, and then immediately what I will do is, as soon as I launch this particular page, I want to verify the title of the page. Okay, so here I will put assert. This is a command we have in WebDriver. So this particular assert command will verify title. So how we can put is, here I will pass exact title of the page. Actual title of the page is this one, and now I need to verify this in driver.title. So driver.title will return the title of the page. Now assert, this particular title is there in this title or not, I'm verifying. Okay, if the title is equal, and then it returns true, and it, or else it returns false. And then I will also enter some username, password, and then I click on the login button. So driver dot find element by name, and here I'll provide the name of the username. So if you go and see the identify this element here, and then you can see name is username. Capture this and specify here, and here I will put some value called send keys, or I'll pass some username called Mercury, and similarly I will also pass password find element by name, and here the password field is identify this password, and the name is password, then pass it, and then again send keys of say Mercury. All right, now we have entered username and password, and then you need to click on the sign in button. Now inspect the sign in button, right? So this is a sign in, and let's capture this name is available or not. So name is available, let's copy this. Now driver dot find element by name, specify the name dot click is the action method. So this is automation code. Now what I want to do is, I want to wait after opening this URL. So this, let us say this will take some time. Let's say opening URL takes some time. Let us assume this URL takes some time to open the page. Okay, so by that time what happens is, the script will continue to execute this particular code. So our code will be failed. So what I want to do is, after opening this particular URL, I want to wait for here. I want to wait some time here. Okay, wait some time here. After opening this URL, then it will continue the rest of the code. So if you want to wait here, okay, what I can do is, I'll just insert implicit wait command. So how to do the implicit wait command? Driver object dot implicitly wait. Here we need to specify time in some time, seconds. The time also specify in the seconds. This is called as an implicit wait statement. Now what happens is, as soon as the page's URL is trying to open, okay, after opening the URL, it will wait here. After opening the URL, it will wait here, and then rest of the statement will be continued. And one more important point we need to remember here is, implicit wait will applicable for all the elements on the page. Okay, so implicit wait is applicable for all the elements which are present in the page, and it will wait for this particular page, and it will wait for this element, everything. So whichever element is taking some time, right, so there and all, this implicit wait automatically wait for maximum 10 seconds. Okay, maximum 10 seconds. Right, so here it will maximum wait for 10 seconds whenever the element or page is loading is taking some time. And 2 points we need to remember, this particular wait statement will applicable for all the elements on the page. And second point is, we can just specify this wait statement only one time at the beginning of the code. Only one time I have to specify this. Okay, now let us see the execution. So now let me just run this code. Now it launches the browser, opens the URL, and continue with the username and password. So when you will see this effect means whenever this URL is taking some time, right? So that time it will, you will see the effect of this particular implicit wait statement. Okay, so this is a one of the statement we have in WebDriver to solve a synchronization problem. All right, so in the next video I'm going to show you how to use explicit wait. So that's all for this video. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.